Forms are often a cause of accessibility problems on websites. There are a few things you need to do to make sure that everyone is able to complete the forms on your site. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to make a form easy to understand and easy to navigate through, as well as the proper use of the label element. The first thing you should be thinking about when creating a form is whether it is easy for the user to fill out. For example, this form you see here. You don't really need to collect all of this information just to send out a newsletter. In contrast, this website only asks for your email address. Only ask the questions you really need to know. The longer a form is, the less likely users are to fill it out. Also, think about how the specific questions you're asking may cause problems for users with disabilities, such as making the phone number field on a contact form required. Users who are deaf or hard of hearing don't necessarily have phones. Many will have a cell phone, but if they give you the number, there needs to be a way they can tell you it's only for text messages and not calls. Don't make phone number required, and add another question to ask if they prefer to be contacted by phone, email, or text message. Even many users who aren't disabled would appreciate being given a choice of how to be contacted. It's a good idea to tell people upfront any unusual information they need to complete a form. People can easily enter the basics like their own name and address, but if you ask for something like a driver's license number, they might not have it handy. This form is especially complicated, and it tells users what information they need right up front. In the Getting Ready section, there's a link to an entire separate page that explains exactly what the applicant will be asked to provide as far as medical records, job history, and other personal information. Then, under Apply and Complete, it tells them how long it will take to complete the form, 1 to 2 hours, and that they can save their information as they go. On long forms, the ability to save as you go will increase usability for everybody, but it's especially important for people with physical or cognitive disabilities who may take longer than usual to complete the form. It's incredibly frustrating when a form times out and loses all your information. The ability to save means users won't have to worry about that. Make sure the form fields are in a logical order in the HTML, as that is the order that a keyboard-only user will use to tab through the fields, or that a screen reader will read the fields to a user. On this form, when you tab, it goes left to right in each row of fields. Generally, this won't be a problem for most forms, but if you use CSS to rearrange fields visually on a page, a non-intuitive tabbing order could cause confusion for anyone who is tabbing through the form fields. Make sure that fields are clearly highlighted when tabbing through the form so that users can see which field they are typing in. The browser will give selected fields a style by default, but adding a more visible style like this will make it easier for keyboard-only users to see where they are on the page. Labels are very important for web forms because they tell the user what to enter in each field. Be as specific as possible, but also try to keep them short. This form has very straightforward labels that are easy to understand. Don't make users guess what they need to enter. If you want them to create a password, tell them up front whether it must have or can't have certain symbols, numbers, etc., as this form does. If there are other fields with specific requirements, let the user know. For screen reader users, one of the most important things for accessibility is to make sure each label element is properly associated with the field it corresponds to. Just having them next to each other visually on the screen isn't enough, since screen reader users can't see that.
Please fill out the following information to receive our newsletter. First name, edit text, blank. Last name, edit text, blank. Email address, edit text, blank. Send button.
If you don't associate them using code, users may not be able to figure out which label goes with which field. First, use the for attribute to tell the screen reader that a label goes with a certain input. The for value on the label should match the ID value on the input element.
First name, group, first name, edit text, last name, group, last name, edit text.
For more tips, check out our resources section for links to articles and other tutorials that can help you expand on the concepts we've covered here. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to check out the other Take 5 videos, as well as the entire course catalog here at Gymnasium.